Hello. Today I saw something that really horrified me. I was really horrified by this. I saw photographs of Boko Haram members, so-called repentant Boko Haram members graduating. About 601 of them. You know, they were in their brand new graduation clothes sewn for them by the Muhammadu Buhari government, green and white. They looked, you know, very smart. They looked very, very well detailed. And they had canopies out lined up for them. And you can see that they had festivities to mark their graduation. Now, this is coming at a time when the General Muhammadu Buhari administration has locked down the schools in Nigeria. All the schools in Nigeria are shut down. And to add insult to injury, the General Muhammadu Buhari government has said there's not going to be holding any WAEC, that is the West African Senior Secondary School examination, this year. Now, Ghana is holding them, Benin is holding them, Togo is holding them. So Nigerian children, 1.5 million Nigerian children take the WAS that WAEC holds every year. So they will be behind their mates all around the world by a year. But Boko Haram, so-called repentant Boko Haram, are going ahead with their graduation. They didn't pay any school fees. The parents of these Nigerian youths, 1.5 million, paid school fees. Yet their schools are closed, they can't write exams. Boko Haram, who are being educated with our taxpayers' money, are graduating. Now you think about that. Think about that. Leah Sharibu, I mean, you see this, my shirt, you see, Free Leah Sharibu. I go around the world, all I wear every single day, everything, even my shorts, I wear Free Leah Sharibu. Leah Sharibu was abducted by Boko Haram. She can't graduate. Chibok girls, they've been abducted by Boko Haram. They can't graduate. So many other children, hundreds of them, have been abducted by Boko Haram. They can't graduate. Now, we have been told that Boko Haram are graduating. You think about that. Just think about the insult. The insult to our national life. How will the world perceive us? You see, I never had faith in General Muhammadu Buhari, so I mean, I can't say I lost faith in him. But I foresaw this. I mean, you can look at my past videos. I remember June 2nd, 2013, Muhammadu Buhari, because the Goodluck Jonathan administration had set up an offensive against Boko Haram. You know, there was an air offensive, land offensive, and then there was like, not sea, because there's no sea, but there was a river offensive from the Lake Chad. And Muhammadu Buhari gave an interview, you can Google that interview, and he said, and I'm quoting, that the offensive against Boko Haram is anti-North. Some people thought he was joking, because I've studied this man, you know I'm a researcher. Now we know he wasn't joking, because that is what he's doing right now, he's petting them. We must begin to ask questions, are there any links between Muhammadu Buhari and Boko Haram? Because this is not normal behavior from a government. This is not normal behavior. Last year, we had the xenophobic attacks in South Africa. I wrote severally, I did a video appealing to General Muhammadu Buhari to send a plane to evacuate stranded Nigerians in South Africa. He did not. It took private individuals, Air Peace and Apostle Johnson Suleiman, who sent planes there and evacuated them. That same month, Muhammadu Buhari sent a plane to Niger Republic to evacuate Boko Haram members and their wives, mind you, back to Nigeria instead. How long can we go on like this? How long can this nation go on like this? Don't just watch this video. Watch it, share it. Let's sensitize our people to what is happening while we still have a country, before we are now like Somalia, or we are now like these other countries that are failing. You can send me an email, info@renoamokri.org. Talk to you guys later.